Hi, this is Brian with Ikan, and today I'm going to show you how to set up the PT4900 19-inch teleprompter. So the PT4900 ships in three layers of reusable foam, which can be used for the PT case. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at these layers. So the top layer is going to have the hood. It's going to have a plug, and it's going to have the glass frame with the glass pre-installed. All right, so the second layer is going to have the teleprompter monitor. And so this monitor, if you look at the back, it's going to have some video inputs. It's going to have an HDMI, VGA, and a AV. And if you get the SDI version, this is going to be an SDI input. And it also has a 12-volt, 4-amp connector. All right, on the bottom layer, you're gonna have your teleprompter riser plates. So this teleprompter includes three riser plates, which are compatible with the most popular cameras. If you're using an ENG camera, it's probably best to get our PT50 riser. That's gonna be a riser plate that actually sits lower for more ENG studio cameras. And then it also ships with the AC adapter. And then here we have the base system where you're going to have your glass frame holder, you're gonna have your monitor clamps, you're gonna have the bottom plate here where you connect the tripod plate. And in this, you can actually unscrew these screws right here. If you loosen them, you can adjust the where this bottom plate is gonna go to help balance it, but we'll get to that soon. It also comes with screws. These are the 3/8 and 1/4-20 D-ring screws. It also comes with an adapter to connect your camera to the tall riser plate. And it also includes monitor mounting screws. All right, to get started, we're gonna go ahead and grab our monitor. We're gonna turn it around on the back side. And then we're gonna get our base system. And we're gonna go ahead and get the Allen wrenches, and we're going to go ahead and loosen the monitor clamps on the very front of the base system, and we're going to go ahead and take these off. So the way you want to mount these is you want to mount them like this, where the long side is facing, they're both facing up. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and screw these in to the screw threads on the bottom of the monitor, like so. All right, and go ahead and make sure you tighten them really nice and tight. All right, so this is how it should look whenever it's finished. So the side with the power button should be here. Just have it set up exactly like this. All right, now that we have our monitor done, we're gonna move over to our base. We're gonna completely remove the bottom plate from the base system. And then we're going to go ahead and extend these rods. So to do that, we're gonna go ahead and loosen these screws here. Just make sure they're loose enough. You don't have to take them out completely, but just make sure that they're loose enough to make it to where you can adjust the rods. So the way I like to do it is to make sure that the rods are about maybe 1 inch in. And then go ahead and tighten it. Go ahead and put the glass frame holder. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead and mount the monitor to the rod system. So just make sure that these rod clamps are loosened. All right, and then just go ahead and slide them in. Okay, so just make sure you got your rods set all the way to the end here to give it the most support. And then once you're finished, go ahead and tighten them. Once this is tightened, you want to make sure that the glass frame holder is as far back as it can go until it's touching the base system. So once that's touching the base system, just go ahead and tighten that. Okay, let's flip it over to the other side. All right, so next we're gonna actually put in the glass frame. So just grab the pre-installed glass frame. And so what you wanna do is you wanna make sure that this hole is gonna line up with this screw in here. So what you wanna do is just simply just slide it in. And what you wanna do is you're gonna hold this back while you slide it in. So you just wanna wiggle this around a little bit until you hear a snap. Yeah, there you go. And then tighten that. And then it should be very secure. All right, so next we're gonna go ahead and put on our riser plate. So we're gonna be using an Ursa Mini in this video. So we'll go ahead and use the tall riser plate. This is gonna be used mainly for cinema cameras. The tall riser plate will mainly be used for mirrorless cameras. And this one, the medium plate, will be used more for camcorders. So next we're gonna go ahead and put the camera onto the large riser plate. So you wanna make sure that you have your quarter 20 adapter, and we're gonna mount it through the bottom of the plate. So this adapter includes a location pin, which this camera doesn't use a location pin, so you can just go ahead and remove that just by screwing it off. So that way it's just the quarter 20 screw. And then so next we're gonna go ahead and get to the bottom of our camera. So we're gonna go ahead and line to the bottom of the adapter plate to the bottom of the camera. And then we're just gonna go ahead and screw in the quarter 20 screw. And you wanna make sure this is nice and tight. So to do that, you have to use a screwdriver to tighten it. All right, so now that it's tightened, we're gonna go ahead and put it onto the base. You wanna make sure that the flat parts of this screw here face the same direction as the base, so that way they can slide right in. So now that our camera is on the base system, we're gonna go ahead and put on our teleprompter hood. So to do this, first we're gonna go ahead and get our boot and open it up and put the lens inside it, then move it back alongside, there, just like that. And then we're gonna go ahead and attach the top magnetic strip first, and then go ahead and do the side ones. So the PT4900 comes included with these side curtains here on the side of the hood. They do help block some of the light leakage on the sides, but you know, you can take them off completely if you wanted. They're attached with Velcro. So we're gonna go ahead and detach them. The last step for the hood is to make sure that it's zipped up on both sides. And we're gonna go ahead and get this mounted onto a tripod. Okay, so to do that, we're gonna get our teleprompter bottom plate, and we're gonna mount a tripod plate to the bottom of it. Make sure that the plate is mounted as close as possible to this protruding part of the bottom plate. So to do that, we're gonna go ahead and line up the screws and just screw it in. We're gonna go ahead and mount this directly to the tripod. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and mount the tripod plate like so. Lock it. All right, so next we're gonna go ahead and mount the teleprompter system onto the base system. So this is probably better for two people to handle this, but I'm gonna attempt to do it by myself. So if you're gonna do it by yourself, I would suggest that you grab it from the bottom of the camera and then the very end of the monitor. That's gonna be the most balanced. So then go ahead and slide it into the base. So I'm gonna go ahead and slide it in. So once it's slid into place, you're gonna wanna balance it properly. So to do that, you're gonna just keep sliding it until you get a good balance. And then once it's at a pretty good balance, you can just go ahead and lock it and then add more drag to your tripod. And then also, you wanna make sure that these screws are tightened very tight to the base system. So the fact that we have this long bottom plate allows you to easily shift the weight of the entire teleprompter system, so that way you don't need a counterweight. So it'll reduce the entire payload of your system, so that way it's compatible with more tripod heads. So basically if you want to readjust the balance of your entire system, you just simply loosen these screws and you can slide it along this bottom plate. And then just once you find the perfect balance, just go ahead and tighten it. And that's gonna allow you to pan and tilt very easily compared to if you just have it completely unbalanced. And it's gonna put a lot less stress on your tripod head. All right, so the last thing we're gonna do is to make sure that the base system doesn't slide off of the bottom plate. So in order to do that, the first thing you wanna do is to make sure that these screws are tightened right here. So what we're gonna do is use this stopper right here. It's basically just a threaded screw that goes right into here. And all you're gonna do is just screw it in all the way. So what this is gonna do is keep the bottom plate from sliding out of the base system. So next we're gonna go ahead and put the threaded stoppers on either this screw thread right here or this one. So since this one's closer to our plate, we'll go ahead and use this one. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and put one here too. All right, and then we're gonna go ahead and put the last threaded stopper here. Screw it in. And there you go, now the system is completely secure. Thanks for watching this tech tip, and for more information, go to ikancorp.com.